I think that moment is a good point. Go to the root and discover the basic structure of TouchDesigner project. So by default, if you open default file, you always have these three components in the root of your project. Those component called project one, and you are opening project inside of this component by default. This object has container type, and it's designed to be root of your interface or main window of your interface, which you are kind of creating for yourself, for making the control interface for your performance. Second component has window type and is designed to output the result of your patch to the visitors of your exhibition or to the people coming to see your visuals or whatever. However, you can basically open every viewer of every node like a separate window, but this window is optimized especially for outputting the result to the monitors. It can output the result to so much outputs you have in your system. But it's very important to understand how it works, because if you open a lot of windows, you will kill performance of your patch sometimes very dramatically. So much better to output one window containing all outputs in the same moment. And I will show you how it works. And third component has a base type, and it's kind of the basic settings of your patch. So you have, for example, some tables containing variables, you have master bit, you have MIDI map, you have basic timeline of your patch. So all local parameters of your patch are saved here inside of local component. Window has a main parameter called window operator. It can visualize either one of panels or one of tops. So by default, for example, perform window is pointed to the project one window. And because this container contains almost no user interface, it's only see one button here. So if I click on perform mode or F1 button on keyboard, I will open this perform window and only see this button. And I can interact with this button. If I want to see the content which is inside of project one, it can be done on two ways. Either, let's say, for example, I want visualize noise one operator. So either I can visualize the content of noise one top on the background of the container using lookup. I go to the background top parameter, and here you can see dot slash. So that's mean go inside of this operator and find the operator called noise one. After that, you see my noisy banana in the same moment on project one background and in perform window. This means this moment, perform window outputs the viewer content of project one operator. But I can do it other way, and instead of pointing window operator to the project one, I can point it directly to the noise one top. In this case, it can be only top operator. And you can see now there is anymore no button in this interface. Why it's done on these two different ways? In case, for example, if you don't need a user interface, this case you can output directly the final content, and maybe it's much simpler just to point it directly to the top you want to output. But in case you want to see the user interface, and for example, this banana need to be outputted to the second monitor, you can use a bit different approach. Let's imagine we have two or three monitor system. For example, one monitor, for example, second monitor. They can be also different size or resolution. And let's say the third monitor. how we can output these three outputs using the same window component.